In today's video, I'll show you how to qualify for the Layer 0 ZRO token airdrop, which is one of the most promising interoperability projects in the crypto space right now. Welcome back to the Virtual Bacon channel, where I teach you how to build wealth with crypto. The Layer 0 network is truly a unique project, unlike any other Layer 1 infrastructure in the crypto space. Today, most blockchains exist in a closed, siloed ecosystem, or use some sort of bridging to send assets to multiple chains. Layer 0 is trying to take a completely new approach to interoperability. They do this by letting applications interact with multiple blockchains at the same time. Imagine you have a DeFi app which uses the full security of Ethereum for high-value transactions while executing small transactions on Solana with instant speeds for a greater user experience. Sounds pretty incredible, right? On a side note, you might have heard of the Stargate STG token that Layer 0 launched a while back, but one important caveat is that the Stargate token STG is not the main token used for Layer 0's cross-chain infrastructure. Rather, STG only serves the Stargate Finance Bridge, which is one application that runs on Layer 0. That's why I've put together this in-depth guide to help you qualify for the potential Layer 0 ZRO token, which is rumored to release sometime this year. Let's jump into it. In order to get the Layer 0 airdrop, the first step you need to do is to set up a MetaMask wallet and fund it with some Ethereum. I'm just going to assume you have this step covered, but if you don't know how, check my YouTube channel for tutorial. Step two is to buy and stake some STG or Stargate token. The STG token is the governance token of Stargate Finance. Don't worry, you can buy any tiny amount and still meet the requirement. I recommend buying it on a cheap network like BSC or Arbitrum instead of Ethereum. This will save you some bit of gas fees. But don't buy on a centralized exchange because the whole point is to link a purchase to your wallet. So if you buy it on an exchange and transfer it in, I don't think that will qualify. You can find all the decentralized exchanges to purchase the STG token on tools like DexTools. After you buy it, go to stargate.finance to stake the STG token. So I'll show you this. On the Stargate page, go to the stake page and you'll see all the available STG tokens you have to stake. Once you have staked it, this STG token becomes votable, so you get some voting power, which is required for the next steps we want to take. So step three is to vote on the Stargate DAO proposal snapshot. Go back to the stake page and you see here a governance forum and the vote on snapshot link. So go to the snapshot link and here we have all the active proposals for the Stargate DAO. So you can open up any of the active proposals and connect your wallet, and depending on how much STG tokens you have staked, you will get some specific voting power. Now, we don't really have to worry about how much we have staked. We just need to participate in order to get the airdrop. So just go on the voting page and cast your vote to anything. I would suggest reading through the proposals to see what's really happening and make your intelligent decision, but I'm not going to hold you up to it. Also, this is a great way to see how DAO governance in DeFi protocols actually works. So pretty much they all use Snapshot as a tool and go to their token holders or everyone that staked their token in order to cast the votes. So it's a pretty fair and democratic process. Step four is to use the Stargate bridge. Now we want to use the Stargate bridge, which is the official bridge made by the Layer 0 team. So go back to stargate.finance and go to the transfer page and then transfer any token from any two chains. I would suggest transferring from Ethereum to Arbitrum because Ethereum is the native gas token for both Ethereum and Arbitrum. So when you do this transfer, you don't have to worry about some extra token that you need in order to get the gas fees on the destination chain. So just transfer any small amount you want, doesn't really matter, and hit confirm transfer and your tokens will show up on the other side after a few minutes. Step five is to use the other bridges currently powered by Layer 0. So Layer 0 also powers some main bridges that are meant for the Aptos blockchain. The two main ones are LiquidSwap and the Aptos bridge. So since these two bridges are made for Aptos, which is a separate blockchain and is not very similar to Ethereum, you will need to set up a dedicated wallet for Aptos. So the best wallet I have tried for Aptos is the Pontum wallet. I have a link right here, but you can also just Google Pontum wallet or Pontum network and you will have the same page. So the Pontum wallet, very similar to MetaMask, it's also a browser extension. So just set it up. And then once you're done, you should also buy a tiny amount of APT, which is Aptos token, and send it to your Aptos wallet. You'll need this to claim the bridge tokens to pay for gas fees. But again, you don't need to buy a lot. Just buy like 50 cents, 10 cents worth. That will be enough. When you're ready, go back to the two bridges website. So I'll just show you LiquidSwap. And on here, you need to connect both your Aptos wallet and your Ethereum wallet. So hit connect and you see I have to connect my MetaMask for the Ethereum side and then I have to connect Pontum for the Aptos side. Then I can bridge any amount of Ethereum from Ethereum to Aptos. So any small amount would do, and hit transfer and it will enter the bridge. Now, the last step you need to take is make sure to claim the tokens once they have transferred. So because I have bridged some before, you see that I have a pending claim here. So you also need to come back to it after the bridge is complete, after around 5 minutes, and hit the claim button. And this will open up your Aptos wallet and actually receive the tokens on the Aptos side. And now you're done. So do this on both LiquidSwap and the Aptos bridge. Step six is to swap on SushiX Swap, which uses the Layer 0 technology. So aside from just bridging assets, Layer 0 also enables cross-chain swaps, which lets you buy some tokens from one chain and show up automatically on another chain without having to send it in any way. So SushiSwap already integrated this feature, and we'll try this one next. Go to sushi.com/xswap, then pick any trading pair. I'm just gonna, for convenience sake, swap Ethereum for USDC. And up here, I'm gonna swap on the Ethereum mainnet, but have it show up on Arbitrum. So let's say I wanna swap 0.001 Ethereum for some USDC. And when I click swap and confirm swap, what happens is after 4 minutes, I won't get the USDC on Ethereum, but it will automatically show up on my Arbitrum wallet. So this is really cool. I would highly suggest for everyone to at least try this out. And yeah, once you're done that, you have also qualified for that step. Step seven is to try the Layer 0 plus Circle USDC demo. So this is a cross-chain demo app made by Circle USDC, the stablecoin issuer. And they have actually built a native bridge on top of Layer 0 that's built into the USDC stablecoin. So later on, USDC will exist on all the chains possible. You don't need to use any third-party bridge. So you can find the demo here. And again, I'll have the full written guide link in the description so you can find all the links on here. And this demo is currently on testnet. So you'll need to request some testnet USDC and testnet Ethereum on the faucet buttons down below here. Once you're done that, you see you can transfer some USDC from Goerli testnet to Fuji testnet. And just go ahead and do that. These are all testnet tokens, so it costs you no money. And the last step is to try the other Layer 0 apps. This is the one extra step if you want to do more. And there are currently a bunch of community apps built on Layer 0 that are supported on Layer 0. So the main projects I've found are Radiant Capital, Mugen Finance, and OmniX. These are all legit projects that I have heard of before and tried, but I don't know if their relationship with Layer 0 is actually that close and to the point that you can get in the airdrop by using them. So anyone can claim to be using Layer 0 technology, but I wouldn't be putting these in a guaranteed airdrop category. So if you want, you can go ahead and still try these. So Radiant Capital, Mugen Finance, and OmniX. And that's it. That brings us to the end of the guide. And now you have all the information you need to qualify for the Layer 0 airdrop. Go ahead and rewatch this video as you complete all the tasks I covered. And remember, all it takes to qualify for the airdrop is an hour of your time, and you could walk away with a huge profit. So don't hesitate, just start now. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. And if you found this video helpful, go on my website, virtualbacon.com, to sign up for my free newsletter. Every week, I write about the latest market events, hottest narratives, and my personal investing insights. This tutorial guide is also written on my website where you can see it today. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.